Being an ER doctor at the front line, you see that. And one of the benefits of being in the emergency department as opposed to any other fraction of medicine is that you don't get to choose who your patients are, right? You are supposed to see everybody equally, and you serve them with the best of intentions, and you focus on what their needs are to stabilize them. And being in that space for 15 years now, I have seen how hard it is for certain people to get access. So when COVID hit, the inspiration really came from two things. One, when my last patient that I finally said, not on my watch, she was African-American, second-generation African-American woman, single mom who had asthma. Her mother was already in the ICU, and she was bound to go in the same direction. And I was trying my best to take care of her. And she said she would not come in the hospital. She didn't trust what we were saying. More importantly, she had kids who no one was going to take care of. That's when I realized the solution has to be qualitative, not quantitative. It can't be just about how many vaccines are out, how many tests are, how many counties, facilities we do, and numbers, because we know the system will take care of the mass population, right? But there needed to be some thoughtful understanding of our communities and empathy for the reasons why there are social determinants of health to address this issue.
One thing we're trying to do with Shared Harvest Fund and MyCOVID-MD is not to act in the vacuum. Even when we have the pop-ups and we do the testing, we're having people come and actually display their art, display their skills, display their knowledge, right, about the social issues happening today. So we understand we're not outliers here, right? The fact that we have to go into certain communities and really do it, a hands-on, type of community build, shall we say, is part and parcel to our history.
So tell us, what has been done so far? What have you been able to accomplish, and where have you seen impact?
What we started with, literally less than 200 people, our pop-up. We've seen up to 600 people. We're about to set up a project with 2,000. We've raised close to $1 million in 6 months in donations towards our effort. Our initial goal was 10,000 people tested. We're now up to 15,000. We've now provided additional wraparound services like mental health services, child care services, job placement. And one of the most important things that we realize is that, there's still a huge gap of who has an access to a doctor. And when people get tested, they have questions. So we've built in something called the Community Health Partners Network. So every single person who comes through our pop-ups testing site gets connected to a CHP. And so they have a doctor to at least talk through the COVID pandemic through. And then they're also linked to a mental health officer to do the same.
JD, when you look at what is being done with MyCOVID and also with Shared Harvest Fund, what role can even communities themselves take?
Because when communities invest in themselves, educate themselves, and advocate for themselves, then we can change the system. Right? That's what we've done. I've done many times before with my COVID-MD or dealing with the Shared Harvest Fund, is helping communities to organize to realize that they are the answer. No. What my COVID-MD and Shared Harvest is doing is preparing communities in advance, during, and after. Right? How do we recognize leaders in those communities? Right? How can we connect with change makers in those communities? How can we respect what's already happening in most communities, not just drop in and say, okay, you need a pop-up? No, we're asking first, we're inquiring first, we're building partners.
You are a first-generation immigrant, as you mentioned. What are your thoughts on how a model like this, like MyCOVID-MD, can be utilized in developing countries, especially in Africa?
In the same form that we learned about how you deal with the lowest amount of access to resources, build these community health connections where people are able to get to rural sites and still provide service. We have this clinical officer model. That's what we've done as a band-aid for not having the real, access to real funding. And all over the continent, they've done a brilliant job creating these small silos that are deeply impacting communities with this decentralized healthcare, in whatever format that fits that community. And so that's, in essence, what MyCOVID-MD is. MyCOVID-MD is my doctor from my community, right? Now we scale that in the the platform, using the technology to make it access to these communities that are remote more easily accessible, and then provide rewards to those humans who are doing the impact work. So absolutely, I think this model is a shared model of ideas. I've snatched from my beloved continent to build the idea and to grow it in America, and vice versa. I'm hoping that we can serve in that space as well.